everybody, welcome to Tom's Tavern. And I've been asked by one of the members on our forum how to put a video on YouTube. Well, I'll explain best I can. I'm not an expert, but I do a little bit. But this is my main camera. This is called a Canon SX170S. I'll just bring you in now and you can have a look at this. Obviously, I'm not using this now, otherwise you won't be able to. Anyway, you can work it out yourself. But this is the camera I mostly use. There it is, it's a Canon, and I like this one because it's got a super zoom on it. That goes up to 64 times whatever it is at the times on when you're zooming in. I find that very good. So that's my major camera. Okay, so like I said, that was a major camera. This is the other one that I was using then. This is just a little Samsung camera. I don't know what model it is. Somebody actually gave me this one. But it's quite an handy one for putting in your pocket. You know, if you're going out for the day and you put it in your pocket and something exciting. It's not as good. I don't know if you can notice any difference from the quality now I've swapped over. But on this, the zoom isn't half as good as that one. The good thing about this is that you can have a front camera as well, so that I can see myself when I've got the camera in. So if that's a good thing or a bad thing, I don't know. But anyway, that's the difference. So those are two cameras that I have. Now then, so what we do when we've took a camera is we put it into your computer first of all, and I'm going to show you how to do that now. Okay, so now we've got to get the stuff from the camera onto the computer. So what I'm going to do is to plug this camera into the UBS socket. All computers have UBS sockets. And then when I switch this camera on, it's in this UBS socket, it'll say connecting to computer. And then you probably heard that go blip 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 blip. And you see there it says import pictures. So we click on that, and there it's going to import them. But it gives me chance to type in there the name that I'm going to call it. So we'll put on video lesson, LESSON. So then I click import. Oh, and it's going, you know, importing one off two, and tick that box, so it'll erase that when it's in. So now that's in. And there it's showing me those two there. I click on that and it should show me what it is. There we go. That's me showing you about the other camera. Okay, so we'll stop that for now. And we'll go on to the next stage. Right, so now we've got the videos into the computer. We need to get them. We need to make a movie out of them. So we press the lessons of Movie Maker. We go to Movie Maker, press Movie Maker, and this brings on Movie Maker. Now then, up here where it says import videos and photographs. Touch that, and then that'll take you into computer. Now I know mine are in Lotal Disk D, so I'll go down to there and look for that one that I labelled video lesson there and click that. So it clicks that, and there's two. One, videos and import again. Two. Right, so we go to the first one. I think I need to move this over here so you can see that better. There's the two videos that's in, so I'm going to drag that. I don't know why it's a bar that goes across there, and it'll play. Start to play. But this will show you now the stuff that you, I don't want you to see. Then I'm counting down to 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And then I will press up here, edit, the start point. So that becomes the start point of the video. Press that. So now when I drag that bar back to there, we don't get that me walking up in the 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We just get that. So I'll stop that now, and that's what we do. You play that scene there, and then when it comes to the end, you see I can, when this comes to the end, then I'll walk away from to turn the camera off. Right, so I don't want you to see that. So this is what I'll do. Just before I get up, oh, too fat, just drag that down a bit. Right, I'll stop that there and push and press set endpoint. So now you won't see that. You've just gone straight onto the other video. And then when all that's finished and you've got it all you want, you press the on button, you press the save button, and then it'll ask you for it to put the name, so you put what shall we call that, lesson to upload and press save. And you see it's going to the server, and that'll take, well, it's going up pretty fast. And that is saving it into the computer again. In my case, under pictures. You could put it anywhere you like. You could put in videos, pictures, documents, uploads. I don't know about uploads. And it's there saved. Saved forevermore. Well, it's saved to you. Tell you as long as you want it. Now then, see, your video file is uploaded. Now one time you could press the YouTube button and it would go up to YouTube, but that service is now stopped. You can't have that. So what we have to do now is go off here. Go off here. And we need to go to YouTube. YouTube, and in my case, this is my account. You need to have an account. See that little arrow there, upload. Right, so you press the upload, and then you get this detail, select file. So you go to your select file. In this case, we're in pictures. And what did I call it? Lesson. So it'll be under L. Too far. Lesson to upload. Press that. And now that's going up to YouTube. And it's going up pretty fast there. See, it's 34%. Almost there. And once it's already there, just press publish. And that'll go up as a lesson. Right, so that'll be live on YouTube in a few minutes. It uploads and then it goes through a processing period. Right, so we'll wait for that to happen. Meanwhile, right, so that's how I do it. And I'm on Windows 7. If you've got Windows 10, then you won't have Movie Maker. But you can download Movie Maker to Windows 10, but it's a different thing. And I'm talking polyparroting there, because I don't really know. I haven't got Windows 10. I've got Windows 7 and Movie Maker, right? If you haven't got Movie Maker, if you're on something else, some other format altogether, then you need to download an editing program so that you can edit the scenes. But you don't need to edit them. You don't need to put on Movie Maker. You could make them direct straight up to YouTube. You need to make an account first with YouTube. And then you can just upload them straight there without editing. You know, I edit them, because then you can put them together and you can take your beginnings and your ends off. But that's up to you. You know, you can just go and point it to whatever you photograph, point it there, and then put it in your computer, and then upload it to YouTube straight from your computer without editing. That's up to you, but that's how I do it. So anyway, I hope that's been informative to you, and we'll see you shortly.